developing major mole just found in Trump's White House. It's way worse than we thought, by Kat Stevens for DailyVine.com. News from Washington is a constant stream of confusing political jargon that could confuse the most diplomatic of political translators. To make matters worse, the White House press corps isn't getting all of their information at the official briefings. The White House under the Trump administration has been riddled with leaks, some of which have been accurate and some haven't. It's believed that whoever is leaking is a holdover from the Obama administration or is sympathetic to the former president, possibly working with officials who serve under him. The latest information coming from lawmakers in the know is that someone on the House Foreign Affairs Committee knows where the ever elusive White House leak is coming from. According to these reports, the number of people that it could be was just severely limited because of the information that was leaked. If this information is correct, it will mean some long-awaited pink slips are handed out and possibly criminal charges. Thanks to what looks like a slip-up on the part of the leaker, the Conservative Tribune reports that information given to the Washington Post put the leaker in a tiny little circle that includes National Security Advisor H.R. McMaster. Word that Trump ignored the written advice of his National Security Advisors to congratulate Russian President Vladimir Putin on his rigged election. When during a phone call, what do you mean rigged election? What? Word that that Trump ignored the written advice of his national security advisors to congratulate Russian President Vladimir Putin on his rigged election? When during a phone call Tuesday, had the nation's capital in an uproar this week? And had some top Republicans saying there is only a short list of possible sources for the leaks? What do you mean rigged election? He won it 75%. A national security advisor, McMaster, is going to have a lot to answer for. He's the culprit in all of this. And I can't understand why Trump tweeted, he will always be, a good friend or whatever the... in his tweet about McMaster's praising him, but I said, oh, well, maybe he's just playing a game here. It was a scene reminiscent of the earliest days of the Trump White House when leaks to the media were occurring on a daily basis. It seems like an hourly basis now. Trump had barely talked publicly about the phone call during a joint news conference in the Oval Office with Saudi Arabian Crown Prince Mohammed bin Salman before the Washington Post was reporting the leak. According to the Post, Trump ignored specific warnings from the National Security Advisors Tuesday when he congratulated Russian President Vladimir Putin on his re-election, including a section in his briefing materials in all capital letters stating, do not congratulate, according to officials familiar with the call. I would say, who are you to tell me who to congratulate and who not to? I mean, really? I'm the president, right? Unless they have some specific reason that I would know prior to that phone call, right? Obviously, those officials familiar with the call probably weren't supposed to go blabbing about their insights to the media, much less the anti-Trump Washington Post. Of course not. And just as obviously, there has to be a very small number of people who could have known enough about the situation to talk. What might not be so obvious, though, is that the leak itself might be a crime. Of course it's a crime. North Carolina Republican Rep. Mark Meadows, the chairman of the Conservative House Freedom Caucus, told reporters at a Heritage Foundation event on Wednesday that the leak had to come from the White House National Security Team headed by McMaster, according to the Washington Examiner. Here's the big deal. If you've got the National Security Council team leaking to the press, that's a big deal, he said at a conversation with conservatives panel, the Examiner reported. Quite frankly, some of the other stuff they've leaked is actually a crime, he added. Among other lawmakers, the substance of the call was most more important. Arizona Senator John McCain, for instance, criticized the call as giving Putin's re-election a Democratic legitimacy. Of course it was Democratic legitimacy. He won hands down. Who are they going to get? Are you kidding me? That it didn't deserve? No, John McCain, you don't deserve the respect of the American people. That's my take on it. But they're missing the point. Trump has been tougher on Russia, exactly, than the doormat presidency of Barack Obama ever was. That's so true. As Representative Trey Gowdy pointed out on Fox News on Sunday, that doesn't mean he can't talk to the hard case in the Kremlin. Of course not. Yeah, with his interview, Trey Gowdy, who laughed when Mitt Romney said Russia was our number one geopolitical enemy, and it wasn't President Trump who handed that awkward reset button to the Russians. Vladimir Putin is going to be the leader of Russia for the foreseeable future. A shared phone call between the president of Russia and the president of the United States doesn't mean the countries are friends any more than contacts between previous American presidents and the dictators of the Soviet Union would have meant both sides weren't fighting the Cold War to the death. America won and the Soviet Union died thanks to Ronald Reagan. No one accused Reagan of coddling the Soviets when he met with Premier Mikhail Gorbachev numerous times in the 80s. But if the supposedly private counsel a president receives is going to be published by the Washington Post or some other news outlets in virtually real time, the Trump White House and the country as a whole has a real problem on its hands, you think? And that problem seems to be deep inside National Security Advisor McMaster's wheelhouse. It's just the latest time McMaster has been in the spotlight, and it's rarely a good sign. When prominent conservative Sebastian Gorka left the Trump White House in August, for instance, his clashes with McMaster were considered to have played a key role. Florida Senator Marco Rubio, another idiot there, has had his differences with Trump going back to when the two men battled for the GOP nomination in 2016. He said he didn't approve of the call to Putin, but said the leak was worse. Who cares what you think, Rubio? Nobody cares what you think, you traitor. So I don't like what he did, but I really hate that there's someone in his inner circle that's willing to leak this stuff. Yeah, that's a real surprise, Rubio said, according to The Examiner. If you don't like working for the president, you should resign your job. No, but there are moles in there. They're not resigning. They're just trying to discredit the presidency and discredit the administration. Considering how small the number of potential suspects are, this time it might be too late to resign. The White House has been in search of the leak since the beginning of the Trump administration. The prevailing theory at the beginning of 2017 is that there was more than one leak, and while some were stopped, there were still more to be found. However, this could be the most deadly one. If the leaker is really as close to the president as these facts lead us to believe, was McMaster anyway. Regardless of how a person feels about the current president pretending to have his back, that's McMaster. While leaking to the press is something that comes with a heavy personal and criminal price. Time will tell if they'll face real criminal charges. Yeah, that'll be a first. But it would certainly send a message to other potential defectors if they did. Thank God Trump chose John Bolton to replace McMaster. McMaster was, of course it was McMaster. And McMaster didn't care because he knew he was getting out of the Trump administration. It was already said he was going to be replaced, and then Trump denied it, and that's when the leak happened, and that's when he got fired. It said he's planning on cleaning house and holding all leakers accountable. Let's see. You think they should face criminal charges? Of course. We're all waiting in anticipation of some criminal charges being brought against these people. I mean, you know, enough is enough at this point. You know what I'm saying? They're getting away with everything. Let me know what you guys think in the comments below. And again, thank you so much for watching.